Man, I used to have dreams about killing a police officer. In that moment, I would have rather chose to retaliate. But I made a sacrifice and a choice to choose love instead of retaliation.
Okay, Sir Leon Ford, interview take one, comment mark.
When I meet new people, I don't open up with my story. I would rather say, hey, I'm just this like cool, happy guy in a wheelchair. And I do that, one, because I don't really like talking about the incident, right? There's so much more to me, Leon Ford, than being a survivor of, you know, a police shooting. I was shot by a police officer during a traffic stop where they thought I was another guy. They threatened me, they used racial slurs and tried to go hands-on, and I drove off. And when I did, one of the officers jumped into the vehicle and shot me 5 times. That experience, it came with a lot of pain. It was so easy to think about retaliation. It was so easy to be consumed by negativity. And it almost feels like the right thing to do. There was a point in time where I was in so much pain that I wasn't even receptive to the wisdom or the love from my family because I wanted to sit in the pain. Choosing anger felt better than choosing love for me, but I had to make that sacrifice for the people that I love. And at some point, I had a shift where I chose to live for myself. I credit a conversation that I had with my grandfather where he said, life knocks you down. But he said, you know what? I want you to understand that you cannot fall off the floor. He let me know that it was up to me to pull myself up. And I think that what was even more life-changing than getting shot was the decision to live my life regardless of the adversity that I was faced with. My son was born in the same hospital that I was recovering. So it took a few years for me to be fully present as a father. However, you know, my son did inspire me, and I thought a lot about how I wanted him to live his life. I want my full lived experience to shape my son's life. So on one end, I'm preparing the world for my son. Then on the other side, I'm preparing my son for the world. And so I'm preparing my son for the world by instilling values, principles, and morals. And then I prepare the world for my son by building relationships. Unless we build those relationships, unless we learn to respect each other, regardless of opinions, more people will get hurt. I remember sitting down with a few police officers and I just listened to their stories. What do you see in policing, right? And a lot of what those officers want, it was almost identical to what the activists were asking for. The language was just different. If you see what the other side's interests are and align your interests, there's gonna be some way to work together. I'm not just gonna say I love police officers, but I respect them, you know, as men and women. You know, my grandfather always says, I'm a student of all religions, but I practice love. And I wish that more people, regardless of race, gender, religious background, or political background, I wish more people could practice love. I believe first, like, we must have compassion and grace for ourselves. That's where it starts. And I believe that my ability to have grace and compassion for myself then extends outward to other people. If we're going to create the world that we want to live in, that we want our children to live in, it has to start with us.